Hello children, today we will start our discussion from page number 5.8, Charles' law. This law is also known as volume temperature relationship and given by Charles. So according to the first definition of this law, that the volume of a given mass of a gas increases or decreases by 1 by 273 of its original volume at 0 degree Celsius for every 1 degree Celsius rise or fall in temperature, provided pressure is constant. So at constant pressure, if we increase or decrease the temperature of a given mass of a gas by 1 degree Celsius, then its volume will also increase or decrease 1 by 273 of its original volume. Okay, so as given here in this example, that if V0 and Vt are the volumes of the gas at 0 degree Celsius and T degree Celsius, then in this condition, Vt will be equals to V0 plus T by 273 V0. And after solving, this will be equals to V0 273 plus T upon 273. Okay, so here we are using a Kelvin temperature scale or absolute temperature scale. Okay, so according to this temperature scale, 0 degree Celsius is equals to 273 Kelvin. Okay, so after solving this relation, we will come in last the conclusion that V upon T will be equals to constant K2, or we can say V is proportional to T. So this is the mathematical form of Charles' law. Okay, so according to these mathematical relations, V is proportional to T, means if we will increase the temperature at constant pressure, then volume of the given mass of the gas will also increase, and this we can represent with this graph, temperature and volume graph. So one straight line is obtained which is showing that V is proportional to T. As volume will increase with increase in temperature, then second definition which is given here, that the volume of a given mass of a gas is directly proportional to the absolute temperature provided pressure is constant. So we can take out this relationship, V1 upon T1 equals to V2 upon T2. This is known as Charles equation, and this equation we can write in V1 T2 equals to T1 V2 in this form also. Okay, now according to this graphical presentation, you can see here that at 0 degree Celsius, the volume of the given mass of the gas is not 0. Okay, at 0 degree Celsius, because this is temperature in degree Celsius and this is volume of the gas. So at 0 degree Celsius, the volume of the gas is not 0. It is 0 at this temperature, which is minus 273 degree Celsius or 0 Kelvin. Okay, so minus 273 degree Celsius or 0 Kelvin. So in short, we can say that the volume of the gas is not proportional to a degree Celsius temperature, whereas it is proportional to Kelvin temperature. Okay, so at 0 Kelvin temperature, the volume of the given mass of the gas will also 0. So this minus 273 degrees Celsius or 0 Kelvin temperature is a hypothetical temperature at which the volume of the given mass of gas will be equals to 0. Because before this temperature, the gas will convert its physical state from gas to liquid. Okay, so this minus 273 degrees Celsius or 0 Kelvin, which is also known as absolute temperature, absolute zero temperature, is a hypothetical temperature. Okay, students, the next is here, next page. This is given here, a relation between absolute temperature and density of the gas. So according to this, D1 T1 equals to D2 T2, or in short, D is inversely proportional to T, means density is inversely proportional to temperature. Okay, this temperature is in Kelvin, so density is inversely proportional to absolute temperature. Okay, so at constant pressure, density of a gas is inversely proportional to absolute temperature T. Then, significance of Charles' law. Hot air is lighter than the atmospheric air, and therefore balloons are filled with hot air for getting meteorological information, because they rise up readily being lighter. So meteorological balloons which are filled with hot air will automatically rise up because the hot air balloons are the lighter due to the presence of hot air than the atmospheric air. So it will rise towards the upwards in the atmosphere. The next is Galuzak's law. So this law is also known as pressure temperature relationship, and according to this law, at constant volume and for a given mass of a gas, pressure is directly proportional to absolute temperature. So means P will be proportional to T, or you can say P1 upon T1 will be equals to P2 upon T2. Okay, then the value of constant K3 depends on the mass of the gas and its volume. P1 and P2 are the pressure of the gas at temperature T1 and T2. Now, when mass and volume of the gas is constant, okay, so the plot between P and T is a straight line. Such curves are called isochore, because these are drawn at the constant volume condition, isochore. The next law is Avogadro's law, which is also known as volume amount relationship. According to this law, equal volumes of all the gases under the same conditions of temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecules. So if we are going to put the number of molecules in the terms of number of moles, then in that condition we will be directly proportional to n, where small n is number of moles of the gaseous molecules, or V will be equals to Kn. Okay, where we know that one mole of a gas is containing 6.02 into 10 to the power 23 molecules, and this number is known as Avogadro's number or Avogadro's constant. Then molar volume. Volume of one mole of the gas is known as its molar volume. Volume occupied by one mole of the gas is called molar volume, and this volume equals to 22.4 liters. Okay, so molar volume value is 22.4 liters or 22400 cc or milliliter. Okay, students, The next page, ideal gas equation. This is page number 5.11. Ideal gas equation. Okay, so this equation we can obtain with the help of different laws, and these laws are Boyle's law, Charles' law, and Avogadro's law. So as we know that according to Boyle's law, V is inversely proportional to P at constant temperature, and V is directly proportional to T at constant pressure and number of moles of the gas, means molecules of the gas. And at last, according to Avogadro's law, at constant pressure and temperature, V is proportional to number of moles of the gas. So after combining all these laws, we will get V is proportional to NT upon P, or V will be equals to R NT upon P, where R is universal gas constant, or after conversion PV will be equals to NRT. So this equation, this relation is known as ideal gas equation. So this equation is for N moles of the gas, and if we are going to take 1 mole of the gas, then it will be converted in the form of PV equals to RT. Okay, so this is for 1 mole of the gas, and this is for N moles of the gas. So where R is a constant, which is known as universal gas constant. Now this relation, this equation is known as combined gas law. Okay, and according to this combined gas law, P1 V1 upon T1 equals to P2 V2 upon T2. Definition: the equation which gives simultaneous effect of pressure and temperature on the volume of fixed amount of the gas is known as ideal gas equation or equation of state. Okay, so this is ideal gas equation, PV equals to NRT, and this is combined gas law, combined gas equation or combined gas law. Then different forms of ideal gas equation. So first is PV equals to NRT. This is for N moles of the gas, where N is W upon M. W is given mass of the gas, and M is molecular mass of the gas. Or you can convert this relation in the form of PV equals to WRT upon M. Then second form, P equals to NRT upon V. So where this N upon V will be equals to C. C is representing molar concentration. So we can write P equals to CRT, where C equals to N upon V, which is mole per liter or molar concentration. Now, when density of the gas is given, then P will be equals to DRT upon M, where D is mass upon volume. Mass upon volume of the gas. Okay, so this is gram per liter, D. So if density will be given, then P will be equals to DRT upon M. Then different values of gas constant R is given in different units. You will learn these values by heart. After this, numerical, example numericals. So you will try to solve these examples, and these all content we have, most of the content of this chapter we have already studied in lower classes, especially in 9th class. So I don't think you will face any problem up to here. Up to here. Now, after that, we will start with page number 5.21. And this content from here will be new for you. Okay, students? So just go through all these pages we have completed. And if you are facing any problem, you can share it to me. Thank you very much.